Najib Razak sat alone in the dock as he had done so for the last 51 days of the SRC International trial, as the court heard how his trusted aides vanished into thin air when the defeated Prime Minister fell from grace. He stoically stared ahead as the prosecution's last witness told the court that both Low Tek Joe and Nick Faisal Ariff Kamil disappeared rather than cooperate with the authorities investigating fund transfers to Najib's private bank accounts. By the Malaysian insight, this is the people versus Najib Razak. Follow us into the courtroom where it all happens. I'm Patrick Teo. Proceedings for the SRC trial only commenced after lunch today. In the morning, Najib and his team of lawyers were at the highest court in the country, the federal court, to appeal for the 1MDB trial to be delayed. That appeal was rejected, and the 1MDB trial will start on August 28th. The defence is given 2 weeks to go over pre-trial evidentiary documents, which Attorney General Tommy Thomas said would be handed over to the defence later today. At the Kuala Lumpur High Court, Najib arrived at 10 past 2pm. He had the same outfit on from this morning, a striped blue suit and a dotted tie. He was, as usual, flanked by his bodyguard and aides. As he was already late, he quickly made his way up to the fifth floor courtroom where day 51 of the SRC trial was about to begin. He immediately took his seat in the accused's dock as Judge Muhammad Nazlan Muhammad Ghazali walked in. DPP Ishak Yusof continued his examination of the prosecution's final witness, MACC investigating officer Rosli Hussein, who took the stand for the first time last Friday. Rosli was again dressed in his official uniform, a dark blue jacket with gold buttons. Today, the witness told the court that on June 18, 2018, the MACC had issued a media statement calling for more information on fugitive businessman Low Tek Joe, or better known as Joe Low. Joe, the commission said, would be a key witness in the SRC investigations. He said that officers had also gone twice to Nick Faisal Ariff Kamil's houses and office in Shah Alam and Bangsa, but the SRC CEO was also gone. Like Joe, Nick Faisal is also at large. One of Nick's staff told the officers that Nick had fled the country and was not coming back. Officers had also gone to Joe's Tanjung Bunga house on Penang Island, as well as Joe's father's office. His whole family was missing, Rosli said. Nick and Joe's passport information showed that Nick left the country on May 7, 2018, 2 days before the 14th general election, while Joe fled 3 weeks later on May 29th. Neither have returned since. Rosli said no one responded to the public request for more information on Joe Low. What happened then, Yvonne?
Giving us a bit of background, Rosli said that in 2015, which was the year the 1MDB and SRC scandals broke, MACC officers had managed to track down Nick Faisal in Jakarta and Joe Low in Abu Dhabi. Both gave their statements and promised to cooperate and return to Malaysia to bear testimony. This assurance was why they were not arrested then, Rosli said. However, when both did not keep their word but went into hiding instead, Rosli said he worked with Interpol to issue a red notice for the capture of both men. A red notice is a request to international law enforcement to locate and provisionally arrest a person pending extradition, surrender, or similar legal action. Rosli said the notice was sent to countries where the two men were most likely hiding: Hong Kong, Macau, Thailand, Indonesia, and China. The officer confirmed that both men held Malaysian passports and both passports were cancelled in 2018. Joe Low also held citizenship of St. Kitts and Nevis, a two-island country situated between the Atlantic Ocean and the Caribbean Sea. Rosli said the MACC reached out to its government but received no response. As Rosli gave his testimony, Najib just stared ahead in the dock, his face expressionless.
Along with their boss, Joe Lowe's associates had also fled the country in May 2018. Rosli said that arrest warrants had also been put out for Terence Gay, Eric Tan, Casey Tang, and Jasmine Liu, whose whereabouts are currently unknown. He also explained that MBank could not produce original documents to the MACC because the central bank had already seized them. These documents were SRC's bank statements, Najib's bank statements, remittances, confirmation advice, and checks. He said the commission then wrote to Bank Negara requesting for those documents, which were later handed to the MACC. Rosli spent the rest of the day going over those documents with DPP Ishak and verifying them. And with that, court was adjourned. The SRC trial will go into its 52nd day tomorrow. This podcast is produced, written and mixed by Revati Supramaniam, Yap Pik Kwan, Yvonne Lim and Ravin Palanisamy. Additional reporting by Bede Hong and Timothy Acharyam. I'm Patrick Teo.